This is concept code number 4. In this particular program, we shall be doing a little bit of manipulation using pointer variables to further enhance your understanding of pointers. So I have declared two short ints, si and sj, and I have initialized them with the values 10 and 20 respectively. In the next step, I have declared two pointers to short integer type of data. IPTR contains the address of SI, and JPTR, I have made it null, that means it does not contain any address. The advantage of making it null is, if I fail to make it null, JPTR will contain some random address, and it's never a great idea to hold some random address in a pointer variable, because accidentally you may use it and bring down the system. So IPTR contains the address of SI. So star IPTR will print 10. Now in the next step, what I have done is, I have copied the address of IPTR, or whatever is the address contained in IPTR, to JPTR. I can do this because both are of the same type of pointer variables. So JPTR will also contain the address of SI. Now in this step, what I am doing is, I am saying SI is SI into 5. What is the value of SI? SI is 10. 10 into 5 is 50. So at this point, SI has become 50. So let's make a note of that. So we are keeping track of it. SI is equal to 50 at this particular point of time. Now let's come to this step. We are saying JPTR plus SI, or we are saying star JPTR plus SI. JPTR is referring to the address of SI. Star JPTR is referring to this particular value 50, and SI is already 50. So star JPTR means value of SI, which is 50, plus SI is 50. So at this point, SI has now become equal to 100. Alright, SI is now equal to 100. A diagrammatic explanation of this problem is done already in the prior session. Now, IPTR is referring to address of SI. Star IPTR means SI is going to be replaced with 100 now. Now, in the next step, what I am doing is, I am changing IPTR with the address of SJ. So, at this point, IPTR is going to contain the address of SJ. JPTR is going to contain the address of SI. So now we come to the last step. We will look at this part. This part is not a problem, because star IPTR is simply referring to the variable SJ. So whatever this evaluation takes place, it will change the value of SJ. So let's go to the middle parts. SI is how much? SI is 100. SJ is how much? SJ is 20. So the middle part leads to 120. Now what is IPTR referring to? IPTR is referring to, here if you see, it is referring to the address of SJ. Star IPTR is referring to 20. So this is 100 plus 20 plus 20. It has become 140. Now we need to just worry about JPTR. JPTR was referring to the address of SI. So what I am doing is, star JPTR will refer to this particular value 100. So 140 plus 100 is going to be 240. So when I print it, it should print this as what? It should print JPTR with the value of SI, which should print 100, and IPTR, when I am doing star IPTR, it should print 240. JPTR is referring to the address of SI. IPTR is referring to the address of SJ. Star will give me value or content at the address referred by JPTR. Star IPTR will give me the value or content referred by IPTR. So it is going to print the values in SI and SJ. This last one is simple, because I am simply printing the value of SI and SJ. If what I have said is correct, you are going to have 100 and 240 as the output of this particular piece of code. So here you can see, as explained, the value of the print statements here is going to show up like this. Let me just bring this down so you can see it more clearly. So this is what you really need to see. So as explained in the last two prints, I am printing the value of SI and SJ using JPTR and IPTR, as well as directly printing the value of SI and SJ in the last step, as you can see here. So this JPTR contains the address of SI. Star JPTR, what is the value at that address, happens to be 100. Now what about IPTR? IPTR, if you see in this step here, it contains the address of SJ. So star IPTR, what is the value at address of SJ? Value at address of SJ happens to be 240. So I hope this clarifies your understanding of this particular concept code, and hopefully it has further enhanced your understanding of pointers.